everyone. Welcome back. I hope you all had a fantastic week this week. Happy Friday. I'm excited for the weekend because it is BeautyCon Dallas weekend and I'm so excited, you guys. I get to hang out with some of my favorite girlfriends and we went last year and we have so much fun. So if you're gonna be at BeautyCon Dallas, let me know in the comments below. I'm gonna be with Leslie, of course, Lip Gloss Leslie, Miss Lola Lynn, Laura, and Dana Ann. We're gonna kinda go together like we did last year. So if you're gonna be there, let me know. I'm sure all of us will be like Snapchatting and posting on Instagram when we get there. So I'm so excited. I just love makeup events. I love getting to meet you guys. So if any of y'all are gonna be there, you have to say hi. So that's kind of my first favorite for the week, even though it hasn't happened yet. We are leaving tonight. I'm gonna be staying in Dallas. It's a total girls weekend and I'm really excited. Okay, so as far as makeup goes, this week we went out of town for 3 days. My youngest son turned 8. I was an emotional mess that day because he's my baby. You know what I mean? Like, I can't even believe that my youngest child is 8 years old. That's crazy to me. But so we went out of town for his birthday. He got to take somebody with him. And yeah, it was a great week. As far as weather in Texas, it was so much better this week than it was last week. We had some sunshine and I love the sunshine. So while I was out of town, I took this. Now this was a limited edition palette by Tarte. It was like one of their holiday sets, but they always have something along these lines. I know they just came out with a new one of those round ones. They always have something that contains a lot of products, but this one has 6 shadows, a blush, bronzer, and highlight, which, hello, that's like the perfect travel palette. Now, it doesn't come with a mirror, but that's fine. It's just so compact, so lightweight, and so easy to travel with. So I used this like all week. I even used it when we weren't out of town. So, and we were just camping. So it's not like I needed anything fabulous, you know? But I love Tarte's eyeshadows. I love their face products. I do have on this, this bronzer, which is in Social Butterfly. I have all of these eyeshadows on. I have pink champagne all over the lid, actually, today. Makes a beautiful eyeshadow and highlight as well, but I'm wearing a different highlighter. But I don't think you can go wrong with these little Tarte palettes. So I know they have like the Rainforest palette and they always have something like this. So I love this, especially for travel. And then this is another eyeshadow I reached for a few times this week and I really use this one a lot. When I first tried the ColourPop matte eyeshadows, I wasn't the biggest fan. This is in the color Selfie, but this is a really pretty, just blending out shade. If you just want to, you know, like this palette, it has a lot of shimmers. It doesn't really have a good, like, kind of warm blending shade. So now when I was on vacation, I didn't take this because I just didn't need to, but, like today I have this in my crease and it's a really good staple eyeshadow. It's a really pretty color. I don't know. I just really like it. It's like I said, the formula wasn't my favorite whenever, look at that. That's the perfect crease shade or transition shade. The formula wasn't my favorite whenever I first got it, like I said, but I've learned to really love it. You just have to use a little bit denser of a brush to really get the product out. So this was a favorite, Selfie. And then for my highlighter today, you guys, I am gonna talk a little bit luxury makeup. I believe when it first came out, it was limited edition, but I saw it on the website still on Nordstrom, so they might have made it permanent. This is an expensive product. It's Tom Ford. It's really luxurious. I actually bought mine from a subscriber, actually, and her name on Instagram is Dressed in Rouge, and she sells a lot of high-end makeup. And she had only swatched this or wore it a couple times, and I'm not real weird about buying used makeup. Like, it doesn't bother me at all. And I trust her. I've bought makeup from her before, so I know she sanitizes it and stuff. But anyways, this is the Skin Illuminating Powder Duo in Mood Light. This is so pretty, and I think it's like $80 regular price. I got it for $55 because, like I said, I bought it used. But it's okay, it's marketed as two highlighters, but this one right here is what I have on as my blush today, and then I have this highlight on, and it is the most beautiful highlighter ever. It's probably my favorite highlighter ever of all time at this point. It is so beautiful for a subtle highlight. It's just like, it's the perfect like go to work highlighter. Oh, it's just beautiful, but you can also build it, and you can also put Fix Plus on it to make it kind of crazy. Like, I like it. That's what I put it on, and then I took my beauty blender and just dabbed it with Fix Plus, and it just kind of bumped it up a notch. But I have loved this brush too with it. Now, this is the Beauty Junkies Pro Highlighter Brush, and it comes in a little set. I think I'm going to do a full review on all the Beauty Junkies tools that I've tried, because like they have a makeup sponge that's the bomb. They have tons of brushes, and I haven't done a brush video in a long time, so I want to talk about the Beauty Junkies brushes eventually. But today I wanted to tell you guys about this highlighter brush. Now, this is kind of, it looks like the Morphe 501 brush, which is always sold out, always. So I'm so glad that I got this, because it's just the perfect way to put on your highlight. It distributes the perfect amount of product. These two have been a match made in heaven. Like I said, this is a beautiful blush, or if you have darker skin tones, that will be beautiful as a highlight too. And this was just the perfect pairing with it. And you know what? This is a really sturdy made brush. I have a Morphe eyeshadow brush that I love. I think it's the E27, but the ferrule is already getting super loose on it. So I think the Beauty Junkies brushes are a little bit more high quality, but they're still very, very affordable. So love that one so much. And then a couple of days this week, I was feeling, a couple of days I wore the blush in the Tarte palette when I was out of town. But last weekend and a couple of other days this week, I was wearing this one by Hourglass. This is Diffused Heat. And when you look at it, you're like, oh my gosh, that is so loud and powerful. You know, but I loved it. Sometimes I'm just feeling like I want a really bold statement cheek color, and this is really pretty. It kind of makes you look sun-kissed, like you had a little bit red on your cheeks, but it has that lighter shade in there. Like, if you're wearing this blush, you don't necessarily need an additional highlight, because it does give your face some dimension. I love it. I don't think you can go wrong with any of the Hourglass blushes. I think they're amazing quality, and they blend beautifully. They're perfecto, in my opinion. Okay. So as far as lips go, I was feeling this color lip this week. Most days. One day I wore a nude, I will share with you, but what I have on right now is one of the new Bite Beauty lipsticks, and this is in the color Saki. Oh my goodness, it's so beautiful. This smells, I don't know what it smells like, but it smells so good, like fruity, but not overpowering. And this is their new Amuse Bouche lipsticks. I think that's how you say it. Now, I'm going to be honest. I don't like this formula. I don't think this formula is as creamy as the old Bite Beauty lipsticks. It almost kind of tugs on my lips, but it lasts for hours. It lasts way longer than the originals. And this color Saki is just perfect. I've been feeling this deep pink color, mauvey pink. And I love the longevity of these. They are comfortable, but they do kind of tug on your lips when you're applying them. But they're beautiful. But it did remind me to get one of my favorite lipsticks out from their original line of lipsticks. And that is... Okay, and that is Rexina. Oh. This is the most beautiful nude of life, you guys. I don't think they put Rexina in the new Amuse Bouche or Bouche line. I don't think they did, but if you have it, bust it back out. It's just the perfect, almost cool tone nude. Oh my goodness. It reminds me of Fergie Daily. It's a cool tone nude, but it has a little bit of pink in it, so it's very wearable. And this formula is so amazing. Like I said, it's not as long lasting as the new formula, but it's also a bit more creamy and more comfortable upon application. Oh, I love Rinsina so much. And then the other one, let me swatch Saki on my hand, even though I have it on my lips, just to show you guys. There it is right there. It's just so pretty. It's so pretty. It's a little bit pinker and deeper than Rinsina. But another one of my favorites this week was one of the Kylie lip kits in the color, what is this? Posy K. This is so pretty. It is so similar to Saki. Like, look at that. So if you can't do a long wear matte liquid lipstick, or you just can't get your hands on the Kylie ones because they're always selling out, try Saki. If you were looking at Posy K, Saki is very similar to it in tone. The texture is a lot nicer, of course, in the Bite Beauty one because this does get pretty drying. But what I would do during the week is I would put on Posy K on my lips, and then around lunchtime when it was starting to wear off, especially kind of in the inner part of my lip, I would pop on Saki, and these two pair beautifully together. I really like the formula of the Kylie lipsticks, but they are drying, you know. But I mentioned another one last week, and I've really been reaching for Posy K. I've been feeling kind of like a little bit pinker this week, like a deep pinky mauve. So yes, those are the lipsticks that I was digging this week. And I guess that's it. I talked about everything that I was loving. It wasn't a huge makeup week for me because, like I said, I was out of town and we were camping, so I didn't wear a lot of makeup. Super simple with this palette, but that is it. I hope you guys let me know if you're going to be in BeautyCon Dallas this weekend. I'm so excited about it. And Leslie and I are going to do a Periscope. So I will link my Periscope in the description box because I don't know if we're doing it on hers or mine. We might do both. But I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend and I will talk to you soon. Bye. And I wanted this when it first came out. I believe when it first came out, my shirt is falling off sticks, and that is... Can y'all be quiet? I have extra kids here this week, so it's very loud.